the NHL Network's presentation of the top 10 playoff series comebacks of the 1990s. I'm Dan Pollard. In 1993, the Montreal Canadiens dropped the opening two games of their Adams semifinal against their rivals, the Quebec Nordiques. Patrick Waugh looked shaky. His childhood idol, Daniel Bouchard, who was now a coach with the Nords, thought he'd found Waugh's weakness. Habs coach Jacques Demers would not listen to calls to start backup Andre Rassicot, and he stayed with Waugh. Ever superstitious, Waugh made one adjustment to his next pregame skate, switching the order in which he skated the faceoff circles for the first time in 7 years. He would not lose another game in the series, surviving overtime twice and leading the Canadiens to the 10th biggest comeback of the 1990s.
Center ice and just missed him with a breakaway pass. Sackick, young shot, Kovalik, a rebound, shooting, and Patrick Waugh on the line makes a key stop. Gusarov, number 5, out on defense with Adam Foote. Cleared in, Domfus, nice move, shooting right on, they score! And Hextall wild again. Hextall going after McCrary big time. Claiming, I would think, that the puck was kicked in. Now, what does McCrary do this time? And it's good. A goal. Have you ever seen a finish like this?
Working against Steve Finn. Gabellini helping out for Quebec. Dion up with it, though. Dion shot. Backhand. Loose puck. Brunet scores!
Breakaway. Cliff Ronning looking for his first goal. Ronning scores! Cliff Ronning.
Messo has it. And Ulanov hands it away. Here's Bure. Scores!
Here's Bure looking for the hat trick. It scores! Three for Bure, and is there any doubt we're headed to Vancouver for game 7?
Housley, the return pass for Kachuk.
Here's the centering pass, Broughton with the shot, and Kirk McLean made the stop. Right wing feed, Lyndon McGroom scores!
Now Ronning steals, has Cortno with him. Ronning works in, Cortno scores! Now it's cleared out, and Cortno gives chase. Here's a breakaway for Cortno.
Tamarashi made the first save, but Cortno gets the rebound. Jeff Cortno ices this with his hat-trick goal.
Broughton's pass into the middle. Gagne's shot stopped in front. Loose puck, and Chevalier kept it outside, but lots of help as Burr has backed up Lischke. Here's LaPointe to Sillinger, breaking in on the right side. Takes the shot, he scores! Casey's out of the net for the extra attacker. Sean Bird is center. Couldn't get the shot. Carson has an empty net. Ellick hooking in. The Red Wings are back in this series.
And it's cleared through center. Gagne away. He's in alone. Great save by Chevalier.
Sergei Fedorov has the puck. Tenorti's caught up by Fedorov, heading for the net. With the puck. Hit the crossbar.
Well, they're going to review this play. We have an overhead look at that. I bet we do. They're just going to make sure. Robbie Schick wants to have the video goal judge, Paul Ryan, have a look at this and make sure that the puck actually went off the crossbar. Sergei Fedorov will have scored the winning goal at 16:13 of the first overtime period. And mayhem ensues and the video replay has given the Red Wings a new life in this series. How about that?
Casey stops it. Chris Dolphins hit a broken stick. The Red Wings get the puck. The wraparound is gone. Joey Gallant.
In the opening round of the 1991 playoffs, the Pittsburgh Penguins trailed the New Jersey Devils 3-2 heading into Game 6, but they were without starting goaltender Tom Barrasso. Frank Pietrangelo started in his place and won back-to-back games to lead the Pittsburgh Penguins into the second round. Little more than 2 weeks later, they lost the opening two games of their Wales Conference Final against the Boston Bruins. Despite the deficit, Kevin Stevens brashly guaranteed victory, a bold statement considering the Bruins were trying to reach the Cup Final for the third time in 4 years. Well, the Pens' history was wrought with playoff failure. Nevertheless, what was to follow would earn the Pens the seventh spot in our countdown.
Here's Murphy. Brings the puck over the Boston line and his drop back. Quick shot. Score! France is scoring for Pittsburgh. Hopefully he's okay. Takes a shot. It comes back to him. Rolled into the side of the net and Recky couldn't handle it. Lemieux takes over. Slides it in. Score! Pittsburgh! Oh, they're skating in. 2-on-1 and Bob Sweeney drilled it. And it was Barrasso with the angle. Covered perfectly. Pittsburgh getting it out. Stevens having to hurry. He's in. He can go. He scores. Stevens with a great burst of speed for the Pittsburgh Penguins. 40 seconds left of this power play. Mario Lemieux left it back in the net. Wesley pumping with a Recky out front of Lemieux. Scores! Mario Lemieux scoring a power play goal for Pittsburgh. Oh, smell it pretty good. Here's Recky. Recky and scores! Recky! Last gasp, baby. Murphy lost the chance to move it out. Now Lemieux, empty net, scores. Mario Lemieux. And that's it.
Deflected in front. Don Beaupre didn't see it, but it was deflected wide. 24 seconds left. Penguins all over the Capitals. Lemieux walks in. The feed to Stevens. The rebound. He carries it. Two goals, and it's 2-0. Ridley, right to Mullen. Mullen walks in. Here's Mullen breaking in. Scores! And it's 4-3. With the Penguins, finds Stevens. Cross-ice Lemieux all by himself. Bork with a drive. Scores! A power play goal. We're tied. Left in the hatcher, elbowing Fenelon. Jagr tries to center. Lemieux in front. Lemieux stuffs it in. 5-4 Pittsburgh. Cut off by Murphy, hit hard by Iafredi. Lemieux to Mullen, and that pass failed to click. Francis with a drive, rebound buried by Lemieux. Lemieux, shot by Francis, pass in, rebound Lemieux, shorthanded goal. Pops over Francis' stick. Jagr, backhands it in, Beaupre down, and the Penguins take the 2-1 lead. The final second stick off is over. The Pittsburgh Penguins defeat the Washington Capitals and advance to the Pacific Division Final.
Ahead on the show, the Oilers stage a comeback and eventually become champions, while the Wings' two-year cup reign is ended by a comeback. Welcome back. We have reached the fifth spot in the countdown. In the 80s, the city of Edmonton earned a reputation as a city of champions, winning 4 cups in 5 years. But in 1989, their two-year reign as champs came to an end when they blew a 3-1 series lead to Wayne Gretzky and the Kings. It had been a humbling loss for the proud franchise. A year later, in 1990, the Oilers trailed the Jets 3-1 in the opening round. The struggles fueled speculation that they could not win it without Wayne Gretzky. But armed with a goaltender who had never won a playoff series in his career, the Oilers rallied and eventually went on to win the Cup.
Oh, drop. They score!
Curry. Cross ice to Ruth Salina. A shot. Traffic in front of the net. They score! Swing wide to Doug Evans. Broken up by the order.
Messier with Anderson. Back to Messier. Score!
Allen goes wing wide. Here's a chance for Mackler. Hollerchuk going in. Saved by Bill Ranford on Dale Hollerchuk. With 1:10 left in the third period.
Through the human, it's intercepted. Messier breaks away with Gray. Messier moving in. Backhander, he scores! Back against Mantha. He gives it to Curry. Curry scores! Here comes Anderson, leaning in against Yumina. Anderson comes in front. He scores! Backhand shot blocked by Kevin Lowe. Len Anderson feeds it to Lamb. He's going in alone. Scores! Race for the loose puck. Anderson's going to go in alone. Len Anderson. Oh, what a save by Red. And Cabot. Tries to control it in the zone. He's checked. Gets it back again. Keegan and lets it go. He scores! Has to be high. Here's Gary Curry going in. Scores! And that will do it. Yake for Rivers. Cross ice pass intercepted by Tkachuk and a breakaway. Gets it over to MacInnis. He's got some time. He scores! What a shot by Al MacInnis!
Somewhere in the back there, it's looming, and the only way they get rid of it is to find a way to win it.
Here's a chance for Young. Young shoots. He scores! Yes! The light came on. It is a goal. The puck came out, and Young has sent this series to a sixth game in St. Louis. 10 seconds remaining with the man advantage. Puck fired in. Not dumped out. Over to Turgeon. Back to Young. Over to the other side to MacInnis. Back to Young. The shot. They score! Picked up back of the net. Turgeon up front. They score!
Ahead on the show, the Avalanche-Red Wings rivalry produces one of the top three spots in our countdown. We'll give you the details coming up next. In the late 90s, no rivalry was as intense as the one between the Colorado Avalanche and the Detroit Red Wings. Colorado had defeated the favored Wings in 1996, and went on to win their first ever cup in franchise history. In 1997, the Wings had upset the Avalanche in the playoffs and went on to win the first of two straight championships. In 1999, the teams met in a highly anticipated conference semifinal. Many were surprised when the Wings won the opening two games of the series in Colorado. Few gave the Avs much hope as the series now shifted to Detroit. Instead, a new chapter was written in this great rivalry, and it earns the number three spot in the countdown.
Leo Fleury brought it in. Deflected. Miller. Score! And it's falling to Pan and Bill Ranford. That went off his glove. That one poked away to center. They've got Clark in the middle. And the Clark. Big save. Patrick Roy. Forsberg still controlling. Forsberg along the blue. Miller leaves it. Shot in front. Miracle score! Intercepted. Hey, Duke coming. Moves it out. Detmarsh in the middle. Detmarsh. Score!
Backer shot on the box. Pulls for the pass. He got it. Denver did scores. Rosalind, Lemieux. Across ice pass. Scores. Peter Forsberg. At the line and now out breaks Forsberg and Kaminsky. A 2-on-1. Forsberg scores. Peter Forsberg has opened the scoring. Fedorov has not been able to solve Patrick Waugh this series. Now a loose puck. Stolen by Denver. And an Oscar sprawling to make a save. Now a puck is in the net. Did the whistle go?
That's the ball.
And the Avalanche have a shorthanded goal. It's 4-0. Went by Brown, who was up in it. And here's the steal. The Forsberg trying to barge in. Forsberg in. Scores! Peter Forsberg. Chicago.
Gets the draw back to Krupp. There's the long shot off the post. That may have hit both posts as it came out. And now Smith comes back for Edmonton. Smith gets in. A shot saved. The big rebound. Garrett lines up. And he scores. Greer goes in deep. Leaves it for Zalapukin. Zalapukin is bumped by Yell. The puck comes free. A wraparound drive. He scores. Patrick Waugh, partway out of his net, heading for the bench. Now he does go to the bench. There's Greer in there. Greer gets the puck. Greer scores! What a great effort by Greer. It's a battle for the puck. And he won the battle and scores the goal. Fires it to the corner. Forsberg gets away from Mirnoff. Out front, the jam away. Reichel was there and couldn't get it past Joseph, but Joseph may be hurt. Brings it back. He has Barahowski trailing. He shoots. He scores! A centering attempt. Back to Foot. Foot with the shot, and what a save by Joseph. Was calling for it. Mirnoff pitches in. There's the shot. He scores! Cinema from the point. Barahowski. He dishes it off. Here's Cinema with a shot. He scores! Beautiful feed from behind the net. Tony Herkus moves it ahead for Garrett, going in alone. Bill Garrett shoots, scores. Now the Oilers come back. Here's Bookberger with Marchand. Bookberger for Marchand. He scores. 3-0 Edmonton. Corbet to the line. He dumps it to the corner. Joseph out of the net to play it around the other way. Greer got hit behind the net. Oh, what a save by Joseph as he took it away from Corbet.
Center, look at Joseph. Right back up. Now he's going. He's past the play. So what do? Desperation, you get the stick back.
Bookberger moves it ahead for Lindgren. Lindgren going in. Lost control and he scores. He bangs away as Watt could not control the puck. And Lindgren hammers it in. 4-0 Edmonton.
Ahead on the show, we'll tell you which one of these teams staged a memorable comeback on their way to a Stanley Cup final. As we saw earlier in the show, the Vancouver Canucks staged a memorable comeback, overcoming a 3-1 series deficit against the Winnipeg Jets in 1992. 2 years later, they would find themselves in a similar predicament. Down 3-1 to the favored Calgary Flames in the conference quarterfinal, they would come back as no one had in NHL history. Vancouver would win 3 straight games in overtime, including a pair in Calgary. The ending coming in stunning fashion in double overtime of Game 7. The Canucks' memorable comeback earns the top spot in our countdown.
Captain Linden has it. He overskates. Adams frees it. Adams cross ice. But Dennis breaks it up. Here's a chance now for Cortno. Cortno going in alone. He shoots, scores! Jeff Cortno has extended the Lightning 6.
acrobatic variety to provide Calgary with a win.
They score! And it's from the point!
He moves it ahead. Lafayette's long shot is steered to the corner. He goes after it behind the goal for Courtnell at center.
And slides it under Mike Vernon. Nothing pretty about this goal. Old-fashioned hard work on a power play. Tremendous hockey game. Guys will be sore after this. When you talk about momentum, this plane ride back home for Calgary tonight will seem awfully long.
Puck goes over to Bure. Bure has it at the point. Deflected to Lume. Lume lets the shot go. Through traffic, the rebound. Bure scores. Tried to flip it up ice. Knocked away. Back comes Craven. Long shot is blocked. The puck in front. They score! Jeff Courtnell pounced on the loose puck in front and slipped it past Mike Vernon for a 2-1 lead. Lume continues to work in deep. Slavsky trying to stay with him. Murray takes it back to the point. Here's Adams cutting for the net. He scores! Roberts moves it ahead to Fleury. Here he comes with Reichel.
Along the boards from Linden.
Brown ahead for Bure. Bure going in. He scores! Campbell Bure has won it for the Vancouver Canucks. It's a triple overtime hat trick for Vancouver.
10 years later, in an odd twist of fate, the Flames would get their revenge for this heartbreaking loss when Martin Gelinas, a member of the 94 Canucks, scored for Calgary in 2004 in overtime of Game 7 to eliminate Vancouver. Thanks for watching the Top 10 Playoff Series comebacks of the 1990s. We'll see you again next time.